Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the 200 best multiple choice questions from the month of October in English language. This is part 1 and right after this, I will upload part 2. So remember, in part 1, I will cover the questions from 1st to 15th of October and in the part 2, I will cover the questions from 15th to 31st of October. These questions will be very useful for you in all of the exams that you wish to undertake in the year 2019. So let's start the video. StudyIQ has some of the finest pendrive courses available for RBI Grade B, SSC, Bank PO, UPSC, State PCS and various other exams. Do check out our website studyiq.com if you want to buy any of our course. Now, Cochin International Airport has won the UN Champions of the Earth Award. Cochin International Airport is completely run with the solar power and UN Champions of the Earth Award was given to Pradhan Mantri Modi. Prime Minister Modi also. Now remember, Prime Minister Modi was not the only one who got the UN Champions of Earth Award. French President Emmanuel Macron, he also got the UN Champions of the Earth Award because Modi and Macron, they are instrumental in running of the International Solar Alliance. And also remember, International Solar Alliance is headquartered in Gurugram and it is a association of countries where there is abundant sunlight so that they can harness the solar power. World's largest bird title has been conferred to which bird? It's a historic bird. It is no more present now. It is called Vorombe Titan. Who has been appointed as the new Vice Chief of Air Force? Indian Air Force Chief is B.S. Dhanwa. And the new Vice Chief is Mr. Anil Khosla. Anil Khosla. Who is the only sports person to feature in the Forbes India First Tycoons of Tomorrow list? The only sports person, and she is the 7th highest paid sports person in the world. She is PV Sindhu. Her yearly income is more than 50 crore rupees. And recently she won the World Tour Finals also. And she defeated Nozomi Okuhara in the final in badminton. Please don't confuse Nozomi Okuhara with Naomi Osaka. Lot of people confuse the two. Naomi Osaka is a lawn tennis player who had won the US Open by defeating Serena Williams in the final. And Mary Kom, she has become the 6th time world champion recently. You know, the World Boxing Championship was conducted in New Delhi. She is also the brand ambassador for BSNL and for Tribes India. World Tourism Day is observed on which date? World Tourism Day is on September the 27. Now remember, the theme of the World Tourism Day was Tourism and the Digital Transformation. And Hungary is the host country for this year's World Tourism Day, that is 2018. And World Tourism Organization is headquartered in Madrid, which is the capital of Spain. Which IIT in India, they have developed a community supported supply of purified drinking water project in West Bengal? Which IIT we are talking about? We are talking about IIT Kharagpur. Kharagpur is in West Bengal. Now talking about West Bengal, they have recently launched their logo. The official logo of West Bengal is Biswa Bangla. Biswa Bangla, and you can see the logo. And Digambarpur in West Bengal was awarded the best Gram Panchayat of India. Digambarpur, it is located in the South 24 Pargana district of West Bengal. Also, West Bengal government has started an initiative which is called Swayang Siddha. It is to combat human trafficking and also prevent child marriage in West Bengal. And Gopal Bose, you know, the former cricket captain of West Bengal cricket team, he passed away. Somnath Chatterjee, he is a former Lok Sabha speaker from West Bengal. He also passed away recently. Right now, of course, the speaker is Sumitra Mahajan and her constituency is Indore. Asian Development Bank has given a loan to West Bengal for $245 million. That is 24.5 crore dollar for safe, sustainable and drinking water project. And remember, this project will be carried out in three districts of West Bengal: Bankura, North 24 Pargana and Purba Madinapur. Israel. Remember, with Israel, India completed 25 years of diplomatic ties in the year 2017. Israel is our good friend. India and Israel, they are also making a missile together called Barak 8. Israel's capital is Jerusalem. And remember, Israel's Prime Minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. So Israel has opened its visa application center in the capital of West Bengal, which is Kolkata, the city of joy. And Basabi Nandi, the famous West Bengal actress, she has passed away recently. Also, the government of West Bengal, they have started a very important scheme called Kanyashri Prakalp. Now, this scheme is not new, but there are some changes that have been made. So, for example, earlier, Kanyashri Prakalp scheme would be available to only those families where the annual income is less than 1.2 lakh rupees. But now, this income ceiling has been removed. Also, an annual scholarship of 750 rupees is provided for unmarried girls between the classes 8 and 11 in the government school, and there is a one-time grant of 25,000 rupees given to the girls. This scheme was also praised by United Nations. There is a Bengali writer called Rampad Chaudhary. His story, Abhimanyu, was made into a Hindi movie, Ek Doctor Ki Maut. Now, why I am telling you this is because Rampad Chaudhary passed away recently. And this movie, A Doctor Ki Maut, or you can also call it A Doctor's Death, this is based on the life of Dr. Subhash Mukhopadhyay, who created India's first and the world's second test tube baby in 1978. The government of West Bengal also started one person, one car policy. That is, the bureaucrats and the ministers, they were told to keep only one car. This is an austerity measure so that there is no extra expenditure on the state exchequer and to prevent wastage of money. The 18th annual Children's Film Festival also took place in West Bengal. The Viswa Bharati University in Kolkata, they received 5 crore rupees central grant for setting up a yoga gram. Yoga gram is like a yoga village. Ashok Mitra, the former finance minister of Bengal, he passed away recently. Now, Tanya Sanyal is from Kolkata. She has been recruited as a firefighter by the Airport Authority of India, and Airport Authority of India chairman is Guru Prasad Mohapatra. So, Tanya Sanyal is the first woman ever to be recruited as a firefighter. Sundarban Forest, which are the largest mangrove forest in the world, so they have been given a Ramsar site status by the West Bengal government. And 43% mangrove cover of India is made by Sundarban Forest. And Sundarban Forest is made by the confluence of the river Ganga and the Brahmaputra. West Bengal government has also launched a scheme called Rupashri. This has been news. So, under Rupashri scheme, a girl is given 25,000 rupees in her bank account for her wedding, provided she fulfills all the necessary criteria, she fulfills all the necessary conditions, and then she will get 25,000 rupees if she turns 18 years old. India's first floating market, it opened in Kolkata at a lake called Patuli Lake. It is India's first floating market. So these are the questions that can be asked, and these are all from West Bengal. Now, adultery is no longer a crime as per the Supreme Court. They have scrapped which section of the Indian Penal Code to make sure that adultery no longer remains a crime. It can be a moral wrong, but no more a criminal wrong. So this is the section 497 of the Indian Penal Code. Indian Air Force has successfully test fired beyond visual range air-to-air missile. Okay, beyond visual range air-to-air missile. What is the name of this missile? This missile is called Astra. Now, let's focus a little bit on Jharkhand. What can be asked from Jharkhand? So, there is a North Koyal Reservoir project. Now, there was a dispute. North Koyal is the name of a river. North Koyal Reservoir project has been started. There was a dispute between Bihar and Jharkhand. But finally, this project will see the light of the day. There is a new AIIMS that has been set up in Deogar in Jharkhand. There is a plastic park again in Deogar that has been set up. And the airport in Deogar will be named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Also remember, the Jolly Grant Airport, which is in Uttarakhand, Dehradun, capital of Uttarakhand, will also be named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Atal Bihari Vajpayee died on 16th of August, and his birthday is on Christmas Day, 25th of December, which is celebrated as Good Governance Day. 2400 megawatt Patratu Super Thermal Power Project will also come up in Jharkhand, and it will be made by National Thermal Power Corporation, NTPC, which is a Maharatan company. The first Khadi Mall also has been opened in Jharkhand, first Khadi Mall of India. Swachh Sarvekshan 2018, that is the Cleanliness Survey 2018, Jharkhand was adjudged as the best performing state of India. Among the cities, first was Indore, the cleanest city of India, then was the Bhopal, and both of these are in Madhya Pradesh, and third was Chandigarh, which is the capital of both Haryana and Punjab. It is a union territory. Justice Aniruddh Bose, he has been made the new Chief Justice of the Jharkhand High Court. He is the 12th Chief Justice of the Jharkhand High Court. And Jamshedpur will be made India's first cow dung free city. India and which country they have formed an alliance to jointly fight tuberculosis? So India will be assisted by United States of America. United States of America, they do two military exercises. One is called COP India and the second one is called Yudh Abhyas. These are the two military exercises between the two countries. Remember, the alliance that they have formed, it is called USAID India and Tuberculosis Alliance. It has been formed in New York and they want to achieve a tuberculosis-free India by 2025. Which city will host the first two new format Davis Cup finals in 2019 and 2020? The oldest tennis tournament, lawn tennis tournament in the world is Wimbledon, but Davis Cup is also one of the oldest and it will be hosted by Madrid. Davis Cup format has changed, so the new style Davis Cup will be hosted by Madrid, capital of Spain. Joal Oram, he is the Union Minister for Tribal Affairs. He has launched Panch Tantra Diwali collection. And he has announced which person as the brand ambassador of Tribes India. He announced Mary Com as the brand ambassador of Tribes India. Who is the only female winner of this year's Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize? The only female winner this year was Aditi Sen De. Asian Development Bank is giving a loan of $500 million to India for which states? Water supply, sewerage and drainage infrastructure project. Which state are we talking about? We are talking about Tamil Nadu. What is the rank of India in the Economic Freedom Index 2018? India's rank is 96 in the Economic Freedom Index. Now please don't confuse Economic Freedom Index with Human Development Index. In Human Development Index, India is 130 out of 189 countries. Number one is Norway and the last country in this is Niger. In the Economic Freedom Index, which I just mentioned, India is 96, Hong Kong is number 1 and Singapore is number 2. Also remember, Andhra Pradesh in India has got the first rank in the Ease of Living Index under AMRUT, Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, which ranks the state as per the ease of living. You know, so Andhra Pradesh is the most livable state in India. In the Global Human Capital Index, India is ranked 158 out of 195 countries and Finland is first. Again, don't confuse Global Human Capital Index with Human Development Index. Both are completely different. In the Global Innovation Index, India is ranked 57 and Switzerland is ranked number 1. Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the Parakram Parv exhibition at the military station in which city to mark the second anniversary of the surgical strikes. So surgical strikes were conducted in the aftermath of the Uri attacks in India, where a lot of people, a lot of Indian soldiers were killed. Surgical strikes were carried out at the terrorism, the focus of terrorism or the terrorist centers in Pakistan. So the question is, Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the Parakram Parv at which place? It was in Jodhpur in Rajasthan. The government has set up a 8-member committee or a panel. It's called Lokpal Search Committee. Now, under the chairmanship of which person has this committee been set up? The chairman will be Ranjana Prakash Desai. Which country's politicians have voted unanimously to strip Myanmar's civilian leader Aung San Suu Kyi of her honorary citizenship? She has also been stripped of the Freedom of Paris Award. This award has also been taken back from her and the honorary citizenship of Canada has also been taken back from her. Myanmar's Aung San Suu Kyi, she is the foreign minister of Myanmar. Myanmar's capital is Naypyi Taw. And Aung San Suu Kyi has been stripped of all these awards because she did nothing to prevent the genocide in the Rakhine state of Myanmar. The controversial 1750 megawatt lower damway hydroelectric project of which state has got an all clear from the government? Controversial because there were some uproar, you know, against this. There was a protest that was against this because it can harm the environment and displace local people. So this project is a project of Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh recently has three new districts. One is called Pakke Kesang. Capital of Arunachal is Itanagar. And then there is another district called Lepa Rada. These are the three new districts in Arunachal Pradesh. And the third one is called Shi Yomi. And Pema Khandu is the CM. There is a high-level advisory group that has been constituted by the Ministry of Commerce to look into the global trade challenges under the chairmanship of which person? This has been under the chairmanship of Surjit Bhalla, who recently resigned from the Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister of India. He is the chairman of the Oxus Investment Company. who has been appointed as the Director General of the Border Security Force. Border Security Force, earlier it was KK Sharma and now it is Rajnikant Mishra. BSF takes care of our border with Pakistan and Bangladesh. Which monument was awarded with the Differently Abled Friendly Monument at the National Tourism Award? This monument is very different, you know, disabled friendly or differently abled friendly. It is Qutub Minar in New Delhi. Now there were a few more awards. So KJ Alphonse is our Minister for Tourism. He launched the Incredible India Mobile App. This has been developed by the IT company Tech Mahindra. And also remember, India will be the host country for the official World Tourism Day celebrations for the United Nations World Tourism Organization in 2019 as announced by KJ Alphonse. The best heritage city is the UNESCO World Heritage City Ahmedabad in Gujarat and Mandu in Madhya Pradesh. Best heritage walk is the Intech Heritage Walk Delhi chapter and Indore Heritage Walk. And the most innovative and unique tourism product is the 21 Gun Salute International Vintage Car Rally and Concourse Show and Coral Safari of Chennai. But you need not remember all of these, just remember Best Heritage City and also remember India will be the host country for the official World Tourism Day celebrations in 2019. Asian Development Bank has approved $150 million loan to establish the first multi-skills park in which state to boost the employment in the state. This will be set up in Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh will be assisted by Singapore for this skill development park. India's first corn festival was observed in which state? It was observed again in Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh, there is a district called Chindwara. And Chindwara is the leading producer of corn in Madhya Pradesh. And Madhya Pradesh is one of the leading producers of corn in India. Who has been appointed as India's next ambassador to China? So, India's next ambassador to China is Vikram Mishri. Vikram Mishri. India has won the Asia Cup 2018 by defeating Bangladesh in the final. This was India's which Asia Cup title? It was the 7th Asia Cup title won by India. Now remember, Litton Das was the player of the match in the final and Shikhar Dhawan was declared the player of the series. India has set up an Ayush information cell in which country? They have set it up in Romania. Romania is a European country and capital is Bucharest. Ayush ministry is headed by Shripad Yesso Nayak. Shripad Yesso Nayak. Niti Aayog has signed a statement of intent with which company to fight against counterfeit drugs in India by using blockchain technology. So against counterfeit drugs, we will use blockchain and Niti Aayog will take help from the company called Oracle. The government of Maharashtra, they have awarded Lata Mangeshkar Award for Lifetime Achievement in the field of music to which person? The person that will be conferred this award is Vijay Patil. Who has won the Ryder Cup 2018? Ryder Cup was won by Europe. Europe. Can you tell me Ryder Cup is played in which sport? Who has been appointed as the chairman of the Press Trust of India? The new chairman of PTI, Press Trust of India, is Mr. N. Ravi. Rail Heritage Digitization Project was launched by India in collaboration with which company to promote 165-year-old heritage? So basically all the anything related to railways in India, everything will be digitized. And the company that has undertaken this project is called Google. Also remember, Project Dragonfly is also associated with company Google in China. $57.1 billion loan was disbursed to which country as the biggest loan in the history of IMF? IMF has given this loan to Argentina. Argentina's capital is Buenos Aires, which hosted the G20 summit in 2018. Also remember, India will host the G20 summit in 2022. A high-level committee on CSR, that is Corporate Social Responsibility 2018, was constituted under the chairmanship of which person? CSR, Corporate Social Responsibility, is what the corporates, they spend when they spend on social services and for the upliftment of society, that is called CSR. So the committee head is Mr. Injeti Srinivas. Loo Review campaign has been launched by India in partnership with which company? Loo Review campaign is basically, loo means toilets, okay? So basically we use Google Maps, we use the GPS of Google, Global Positioning System, and that will now show the nearest toilets also. So we can be guided to the nearest toilets where we can go and relieve ourselves. So the answer is Google. Who has written the book called Godman to Tycoon, The Untold Story of Baba Ramdev? This is a controversial book written by Priyanka Pathak Narayan. And it traces the journey of Baba Ramdev from a godman to a businessman. Pandit Tulsidas Borkar He passed away recently. He used to play which instrument? He used to play harmonium. Which country recently has been hit by Typhoon Trami? Typhoon Trami came to Japan. Who was elected as the president of the Indian Newspaper Society? His name is Jayant Memon Mathew. So J.M. Mathew is the new president of the Indian Newspaper Society. Which state has become the first Indian state to offer a wage compensation scheme for pregnant women working in the tea gardens of the state? First Indian state to offer a wage compensation to the pregnant women working in the tea garden. Tea garden, there is only one state that comes to mind, which is Assam. Which High Court has directed the state government to provide reservation to transgenders in educational institutions and in the public appointments? Transgenders will get reservation. This has been ordered by the Uttarakhand High Court. Who was awarded with the 2018 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine? It was given because they discovered immunotherapy for the treatment of cancer, and their names are James Ellison and Suku Honjo. Central Information Commission has been brought under has brought which organization under right to information? Now the Board of Control for Cricket in India has been brought under RTI. Who has won the Asian Junior Squash title? Asian Junior Squash title was won by Yuvraj Vadhwani. Now remember, Geeta Gopinath has been made Chief Economist in the International Monetary Fund. This is very important. And the President of the International Monetary Fund is Christine Lagarde. Christine Lagarde, according to the recent Forbes list, she is the third most powerful woman in the world. In the top 100 most powerful women of the world, 4 are Indians. And the most powerful woman in the world is Angela Merkel, who is the Chancellor of Germany. She will be retiring very soon, and her ruling party in Germany is called CDU, Christian Democratic Union. Also remember, according to the Swachh Sarvekshan, so Swachh Sarvekshan or cleanliness survey is of two types, rural and urban. The state that got the best performing state award in the cleanliness survey, urban, was Jharkhand. But for the Swachh Sarvekshan rural or Grameen, the award has been given to Haryana. And Maharishi Dayanand University in Haryana, in Rohtak, has been declared the cleanest government university in India. Maharishi Dayanand University. So these are the rankings, and these are the what you call the Swachh campus rankings or the clean campus ranking. Haryana's MDU, Maharishi Dayanand University, is the cleanest. Guru Nanak Dev University in Amritsar is the second cleanest. And the Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences in Delhi is the third cleanest university in India, if I talk about the government sector. If I talk about the private universities, they are divided into two parts, day boarding and residential. Among residential, Pune's Symbiosis University is the cleanest, followed by OP Jindal Global University in Sonipat, and then KLE Academy of Higher Education in Belagavi. If I talk about the non-residential or day boarding private universities, then Raipur's ITM University is the cleanest, followed by the North Cap University in Gurugram, and then CV Raman University in Bilaspur. If I talk about technical institutions, then Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham in Coimbatore is the cleanest, followed by IIT Guwahati, and then Siksha O Anusandhan University in Bhubaneswar. Indian Ports Association, they have appointed which company as the managed service provider for the 5 major ports of India? These are the Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Deen Dayal Port and Paradweep. So this company is Tech Mahindra. Tech Mahindra will provide the IT support for all these 5 ports. Which Indian institution has got the top position among Indian universities in the Times Higher Education's World University Rankings for 2019? We are talking about Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. It is the best university in India according to Times Higher Education ranking. But what about in the world? So number 1 is Oxford, number 2 is Cambridge, and number 3 is Stanford. The government has constituted a competition law review committee to review the Competition Act under the chairmanship of which person? This person again is Injeti Srinivas. Injeti Srinivas. Union Health Minister JP Nadda, he has declared conversion of how many primary health center and sub center into wellness center by 2022. So in India, 1.5 lakh primary health center and sub center will be converted into wellness center by 2022. Lilima Mins has been selected for the prestigious Eklavya Puraskar. She plays which game? She plays hockey, and she is from Odisha. Another two players from Odisha you need to remember. One is weightlifter Jhili Dala Bahera and badminton player Rutu Parna Panda. They are also from Odisha. who was appointed as the Director General of the Railway Protection Force. The Director General is Mr. Arun Kumar. Now remember, Madhya Pradesh has recently made a cow ministry, and after Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh is the second state to have a cow ministry. And there is a new train that has been started by Madhya Pradesh, which is called Cow Express. Donna Strickland from Canada, she is the first Nobel Prize winner in physics, female Nobel Prize winner in physics in the last 55 years. So don't forget her name, Donna Strickland. Who was named as the flag bearer of the Indian contingent for the third Youth Olympic Games to be held in Argentina from October 6 to 18? So who was India's flag bearer at the Youth Olympic Games? It was Manu Bhakar. She is a shooter from Haryana. Now remember, the motto of Youth Olympics was Feel the Future. Feel the Future, and the mascot was Pandy, which is basically a jaguar. Who has launched a national level entrepreneurship awareness campaign, Udyam Abhilasha, in 115 aspirational districts of India? These are basically the backward districts which require immediate development. It was launched by the Small Industries Development Bank of India. It is headquartered in Lucknow and chairman is Mohammed Mustafa. Who has become the new president of Iraq? The new president of Iraq is Barham Saleh. Iraq's capital is Baghdad. The sixth edition of IB Summer. It's a joint multinational maritime exercise between India, Brazil and South African navies. It was held in which country? This time it was held in South Africa. And Johannesburg hosted the BRICS Summit of 2018. Which state has become the first in India to give legal protection to Good Samaritans through a legislation? Good Samaritan are the people, if there is an accident victim, they take that person to hospital and they don't have to face any legal problem because of that. So the first state to actually give them legal protection is Karnataka. And remember, the Good Samaritan policy was first started by the Delhi government, but there was no legal framework for the same. Arkady Vorkovich has been elected as the president of the World Chess Federation, which is called FIDE. He is from which country? Just like in football, we have FIFA, for chess, we have FIDE, and he is from Russia. Facebook has appointed Adam Mosseri as the head of which one of the following mobile app? Adam Mosseri is the new head for Instagram. The answer is Instagram. Who has become the oldest scientist to be awarded the Nobel Prize? He won it in the field of physics. What is his name? His name is Arthur Ashkin. Arthur Ashkin. Now, the 2018 Nobel Prize in Chemistry was given to three people: Francis Arnold, George Smith, and Gregory Winter. Who has been appointed as the chairperson of the National Financial Reporting Authority, NFRA? NFA's new chairman is Rangachari Sridharan. The state cabinet of Madhya Pradesh has approved the proposal of induction of Nevadi as the newest district in the state. This has become which district of MP? It is the 52nd district, and it has been carved out from Tikamgarh district. So remember, Madhya Pradesh, the new district is Nevadi district. It is the 52nd district. It has been carved out from Tikamgarh district. National Khadi Festival 2018 was held in which city? It was recently held in Mumbai, and the first Khadi Mall of India has been set up in Jharkhand. Indian Railways launched its project called What to upgrade 140 rakes of the mail or express trains in the first phase. This is called Project Utkrisht. Project Utkrisht of the Indian Railways. The Union Cabinet has approved the setting up of the National Institute of Mental Health Rehabilitation in which state? Where will the National Institute of Mental Health and Rehabilitation will be set up? It will be set up in Madhya Pradesh. Also remember, in Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal, there will be setting up of a National Institute of Design. Which institution was named the National Coordinating Institute for the Scheme for Promotion of Academic and Research Collaboration, which is called SPARC, under the Ministry of Human Resource Development, headed by Prakash Javadekar? The coordinating institute is the IIT Kharagpur. Which Indian state has become the 23rd open defecation free state? The first state in India to become open defecation free was Sikkim, and Sikkim also became the first and the only organic state of India. Sikkim CM is Pawan Chamling, and 23rd open defecation free state is actually Manipur. Sahyog HopTech 2018, it's a joint exercise between India and which country? Sahyog HopTech is an exercise between India and Vietnam. India has launched Operation Samudra Maitri to help which country? Samudra Maitri has been launched to help Indonesia for the recent earthquakes and tsunami. And remember, three Indian ships will participate. They will go to Indonesia to help Indonesia. INS Tir, Indian Naval Ship Tir, Sujata and Shardul. United Nations High Commissioner for Refugee, they have given Nansen Refugee Award to Dr. Ivan Ataradha. He is a surgeon of which country? He is a surgeon from South Sudan. South Sudan's capital is Juba and Sudan's capital is Khartoum. India and which country they have signed the $5 billion S-400 air defense system deal? S-400 is an anti-missile defense system. India has bought it from Russia. India has signed a $110 million loan agreement with Asian Development Bank to improve the rural connectivity in which state? This has been done for Madhya Pradesh. Sometimes you may see in news 100 million, sometimes 110 million. That varies depending on the value of the rupee against dollar. So don't confuse the two. In the exams, you won't get this close options like 100 or 110. Both are correct. You will get the options like $100 million, $200 million, $300 million, or the question will be reversed, like this much money has been given to which state? The answer is Madhya Pradesh. The 36th National Games will be held from March 30 to April the 14th next year in which state? National Games will be hosted by Goa. Which variety of mango from Ratnagiri, Sindhudurg and other adjoining areas in Maharashtra has got a geographical indicator tag? This mango is called Alfonso mangoes. Remember, there is another mango called Zardalu mango from Bihar which has got the geographical indicator tag in 2018. Also, in 2018, the Bokasol rice from Assam has got the geographical indicator tag. This is a rice that does not need to be cooked. Then we have Adilabad Dokra, which is nothing but a metallic craft from Adilabad in Telangana, and Warangal Duri or Warangal Carpet, they have also got the geographical indicator tag. Kadaknath chicken, which is eaten in Jhabua district of Madhya Pradesh, has got the GI tag. From Bihar, the Katarni rice, which is mainly eaten in Munger, Banka and South Bhagalpur, has got the GI tag. And Zardalu mango from Bhagalpur. And Magahi paan, which is a paan of the Nalanda, Nawada, Gaya, Aurangabad area, this has got the geographical indicator tag. World Teachers Day was celebrated on which date? World Teachers Day is on October the 5th and National Teachers Day is on September the 5th. So don't confuse the two. September 5 is the birthday of the first Vice President and the second President of India, Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. His birthday in India we celebrate at Teachers Day, but most of the countries they celebrate Teachers Day on October the 5th. And what was the theme of the Teachers Day? The theme of World Teachers Day was the right to education means the right to a qualified teacher. 2018 Nobel Peace Prize is given to which person? It is given to Nadia Murad and Denis Mukwege. So the answer is both A and B. Nadia Murad is from Iraq and Denis Mukwege is from Democratic Republic of Congo. The capital of Democratic Republic of Congo is Kinshasa. Who has been appointed as the Managing Director and CEO of ICICI Bank? After Chanda Kochar, now it is Mr. Sandeep Bakshi who will head the ICICI Bank. Ramon Laguarta has taken charge as the Chief Executive Officer of which company? He has replaced Indra Nui as the Global CEO of PepsiCo. Justice Suryakant was appointed as the Chief Justice of which state's High Court? He has been appointed as the Chief Justice of the Himachal Pradesh High Court. 21 countries in the Indian Ocean Rim Association IORA, they have adopted which declaration on renewable energy in the Indian Ocean region? This declaration is called the Delhi Declaration because this event took place in Delhi. India's first methanol cooking fuel program was launched in which state? It was launched in Assam. It's a very important question. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the working committee and the director on the board by the international industry body, the World Federation of Exchanges? He is Vikram Limai. He is associated with the National Stock Exchange. Who has been appointed as the vice chairman and the managing director of the Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services Company, ILNFS? It is Vineet Nair. Reserve Bank of India, in their fourth bi-monthly monetary policy, has kept the repo rate at what? So after fourth, now we had fifth also, and the repo rate is the same. It is 6.5%. So reverse repo is 6.25, margin standing facility is 6.75, and SLR is 19.5, repo rate is 6.5. So everything is the same, and even after the fifth bi-monthly monetary policy, everything is the same. So this is the table that you can use. Which ministry has won the Swachhta Hi Seva Award, which means Cleanliness is Service Award, for its contribution to Swachhta Pakhwada? Which ministry are we talking about? It is the Railway Ministry. In which city was the world's largest dome inaugurated? It was inaugurated recently in Pune, and Pune will also host the National Youth Games, that is Khelo India Games, which are under 17 games in 2019. India's first dolphin research center will come up in which city? It will be set up in Patna. Also remember, the Patna Medical College will be made into the world's largest hospital very soon. NASSCOM has unveiled its Center of Excellence for Internet of Things in which state? This Internet of Things center will be made in Haryana. Who has been appointed as the CEO of IDBI Bank? He has replaced Mr. B. Sriram. His name is Rakesh Sharma. Which player has joined Indian Oil Corporation Limited, Guwahati, as HR officer? Her name is Hima Das, and she is also called Dhing Express. She is the sports ambassador of Assam. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the International Advertising Association? This time it's an Indian which will head the International Advertising Association. His name is Srinivasan Swami. Which state has won the 24th Senior Women's National Football Championship? It was won by Manipur. Manipur won the 24th Senior Women's National Football Championship. Which Indian has won the Anna Politkovska Award, which is given for bravery in journalism? It has been won by Beena Lakshmi Nepram. The center has reconstituted the Supreme Court empowered Environmental Pollution Prevention and Control Authority, which is called EPCA, under the chairmanship of which person? Now the new chairman of EPCA will be Bhurelal. Bilateral maritime exercise between Japan and India has been commenced in which city? It is called GMEX 18. It started in Visakhapatnam, Vizag, Andhra Pradesh. Which of the following IITs has decided to establish an Academy of Leadership? Academy of Leadership, the first IIT to do so is IIT Kharagpur, and the name of this Academy of Leadership will be Partha Ghosh Academy of Leadership. Partha Ghosh is a famous management guru, consultant and strategist. Government has recently released the policy on the biometric based digital processing of passengers at airports called what? To make hassle-free air travel for passenger. This will be called Digi Yatra. Remember, the Bengaluru, the Kempegowda airport is the first airport in India to have face mask, you know, the face image as a mechanism for approval. That is, face scan can be used as a password or as a identity approval. Which of the following religious places has been declared the cleanest religious place in India at the Safai Giri Summit and Awards 2018? It is the Vaishno Devi Temple in Katra, Jammu. The Indian Air Force celebrated its which anniversary on 8th of October 2018? It was the 86th anniversary of the Indian Air Force. Which state government has unveiled Unnati Yojana, Unnati scheme to help the entrepreneur from SCST community? The Unnati scheme has been started by the government of Karnataka. Which state has launched Nirman Kusum program for providing financial assistance to the children of the construction workers for their technical education in the state? Nirman Kusum program was started by the government of Odisha. Famous Gandhian Natwar Thakkar passed away. He was known as which state's Gandhi? Natwar Thakkar was known as the Gandhi of Nagaland. Who has won the girls' title in the IBSF World Under 16 Snooker Championship? Her name is Kirtana Pandian. Who has won the 2018 Nobel Prize in Economic Sciences? 2018 Nobel Prize in Economic Sciences was won by William Nordhaus and Paul Romer. So the answer is both A and B. Which state government has launched a website and a mobile app called Mahamadat to analyze the drought situation? Mahamadat was launched by Maharashtra. Rajasthan government has launched a scheme under which more than 12 lakh farmers of the state will receive free electricity up to how much for a year on their agriculture electricity connection. They will be provided free electricity up to 10,000 rupees for a year. Rajasthan's new chief minister is Ashok Gehlot. Who has been appointed as the new chief statistician of India? He will replace TCA Anand. His name is Praveen Srivastav. Who has become the first Indian shooter to win the gold medal at the Youth Olympic? The first Indian shooter to win gold at Youth Olympic is Manu Bhakar. Prime Minister Modi has unveiled a 64 feet tall statue of the former leader Deen Bandhu Sir Chotu Ram in which city of Haryana? It was launched in Rohtak. Which state has launched the Chief Minister's Sashakt Kisan Yojana? Chief Minister Sashakt Kisan Yojana was recently launched by the government of Arunachal Pradesh. Which country has successfully test fired their Gori ballistic missile? Gori ballistic missile is a missile from Pakistan. Which country has won the Under 19 Asia Cup title? Under 19 Asia Cup title has been won by India. Remember, Shashi Tharoor has written a book which is called The Paradoxical Prime Minister. The Paradoxical Prime Minister. Also remember that Sanjay Baru wrote a book called The Accidental Prime Minister. So don't get confused between the Paradoxical Prime Minister and the Accidental Prime Minister. And for the Hockey World Cup in Kalinga Stadium in Odisha, which was won by Belgium, Hockey World Cup, the Oli, which is the Olive Ridley Turtle, was the mascot. The Ramilani Foundation's Outstanding Person Award was presented to which person recently? It was awarded to Pulela Gopichand, who is a famous badminton coach. Which state has announced to be the partner state in the Goa International Film Festival? The partner state in Goa International Film Festival was Jharkhand. Which state has announced the launch of an anti-terrorist force which is called Kavach? The anti-terrorist Kavach force is a force from Haryana. Which state has laid down the foundation stone of India's first 58-acre second-generation ethanol biorefinery plant? Where will it be set up? It will be set up in Odisha. Central government has set up a strategic policy group, SPG, headed by which person to assist the National Security Council? Strategic planning group will be headed by Ajit Doval, who is the National Security Advisor of India. Also remember, the Defense Acquisition Council will be chaired by the Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. Which of the following organization has launched a innovative mobile health app which is called MedWatch? MedWatch is a mobile app launched by the Indian Air Force. Also remember, National Waterway 40 is being constructed on River Ghagra. National Waterway 40. Which country's passport was named as the world's most powerful passport as per the Henley Passport Index 2018? According to Henley, it was Japan. But remember, in the Global Passport Index, Singapore passport was considered as the strongest in the world. Who has been appointed as the new Solicitor General of India? New Solicitor General of India is Tushar Mehta. In a report issued by the UN Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, it was stated that the planet Earth will reach the threshold of 1.5 degrees Celsius by which year? It is called a threshold because more than this temperature rise the Earth cannot sustain. But we will reach the threshold by the year 2030 itself. International Olympic Committee has made which African country the host of the 2022 Youth Olympic Games? 2022 Youth Olympic Games will be hosted by Senegal. Who was selected as India's first Miss Trans Queen? India's first Miss Trans Queen is Veena Sendre. Rabindranath Tagore Memorial Auditorium was built in, you know, with the help of India in which country? Rabindranath Tagore, he was the first, Indian to get a Nobel Prize in Literature. And Rabindranath Tagore Memorial Auditorium was built in Sri Lanka recently. What was the rank of India in Oxfam World Inequality Index? India's rank was a very poor 147. Who has been appointed as the Managing Director and the Chief Executive Officer of the IDBI Bank? He has replaced B. Shriram. His name is Rakesh Sharma. Indian Space Research Organization, they signed a Memorandum of Understanding with which Central University for setting up of the Satish Dhawan Center for Space Science? Satish Dhawan Center for Space Science will be set up in Jammu, in Jammu Central University. What was the rank of India in the World Bank's Human Capital Index? India's rank was a very lowly 115. Niti Aayog, along with which company, they have announced a first-of-its-kind internship program for students selected by Atal Innovation Mission. So, along with which company they have announced it? The company is IBM. Delhi government has signed a Twin City Agreement with the government of which country for cooperation in various fields like environment, culture, education for the next 3 years? Delhi will be assisted by Moscow, capital of Russia. What was the rank of India in the Global Hunger Index? In the Global Hunger Index, India's rank was a poor 103. India has been elected to United Nations Human Rights Council for how many years? India has been elected for 3 years. Inland Waterways Authority of India, they will be starting the roll-on, roll-off facility in collaboration with the government of which state to provide the much-needed connectivity for Majuli, which was declared a district recently. It is in Assam. Who died due to heart attack in Rishikesh, Uttarakhand after a 111-day hunger strike demanding the government to clean the river Ganga? We are talking about Professor G.D. Agarwal. Which state government has approved financial assistance of 1610 crore rupees for the Tarli Irrigation Project? Tarli Irrigation Project is a project of Maharashtra. Home Ministry has issued an advisory asking which city's administration to exempt the sick women from wearing helmets while driving two-wheeler. This has been done for especially the Sikh women of Chandigarh. The National Electronics Policy 2018 was released by the government. It aims a turnover of $400 billion in domestic electronics manufacturing by which year? We want to have $400 billion worth manufacturing in domestic electronics by the year 2025. Who has written the book called Paradise Tower? Paradise Tower book is written by Shweta Bachchan. She is the daughter of Amitabh Bachchan. Renowned Hindustani classical musician Annapurna Devi passed away. In which of the following states she was born? Annapurna Devi was born in Madhya Pradesh. So this was the video for October part 1. And it was a long overdue, but I'm glad I was able to bring it in English language. And the part 2 I will upload very soon. Hopefully I can upload it within 2 days. So do check out part 2 also of the best 200 questions from the month of October. And the part 2 for the best 200 questions of November will also be uploaded very soon. So keep enjoying StudyIQ and do like, comment, share and subscribe our channel. And let me also remind you, StudyIQ has some of the finest pen drive courses available. These are the self-prep courses for various exams that are being conducted in India. And you can boost your preparation by watching our paid videos also from the comfort of your home. Take care and see you in my next video.